Well, just 18 months after entering Indiana's life sciences landscape, New Jersey-based Catalent says the red-hot biologic sector is driving multiple large investments in Bloomington. Business of Health reporter Kylie Valletta has more. Kylie.
Thank you very much, Gary. Catalent acquired the Bloomington site from homegrown Cook Pharmica in 2017 and is growing it at a breathtaking pace. The company focuses on contract drug development and manufacturing and has announced $114 million worth of investment in the operation during recent months, and executives believe there could be more. Dennis Johnson is general manager of Catalent's Bloomington site and joins me now to tell us more. Thanks for coming to the show.
Thank you for inviting me.
So the Bloomington site focuses on biologics. Explain that niche area of pharmaceuticals and why it's so hot right now.
Well, biologics are larger molecules. So when you think about traditional pharmaceuticals that make up 90% of the drugs out there today, they're small molecules, and they tend to go throughout the body, where large molecules, you can target cells more easily. So if you think about whether it be cancer therapies, oncology, immune diseases, or other treatments where you want to focus on certain cells, biologics is a tool set where by growing the molecules, you can produce much larger molecules that are targeted on specific cells.
And Catalent has been in Bloomington about 18 months. You've grown from 12 commercial products to 20. So fast growth, investing $114 million in the facility. What new capabilities is that going to give you in Bloomington?
Well, it's giving us a lot more capability to produce at high volume. What we're seeing is that a lot of our production and development of molecules have moved through the pipeline, and we have over 20 commercial molecules now and 120 in development. As they go into commercial, the volumes increase significantly. And with that increase, we have to be ready to support our patients and the clients' needs. So we have to double fundamentally our capability by introducing two new high-speed filling lines for syringe and for vials.
Impressive. You've also created or plan to create 200 jobs in Bloomington by 2024. So tell us a little bit more about your hiring plans and just thoughts in general about the labor pool in Bloomington.
The labor pool is really good. We're blessed to have some very good universities in the area and local colleges such as Ivy Tech. We have IU, obviously, in Bloomington. And then up the road, not too far, we have Purdue and even Rolls-Hallman, which both have very good engineering programs. So we're really lucky, and we've been able to grow. And in fact, we're probably running ahead of our original plans. Today, we're over 950 people here on site. And when you go and look at the site 10 years ago, we were 270. We believe in the next 3 months we'll actually top out at 1,100 for the year.
Oh, that's good news for the Bloomington area. What sort of disease states do the products that you make there? What disease states do they really tackle? Can you tell us that?
Well, I can't speak about specific clients, but I can say that we do business with 18 of the largest 25 biotech companies out there. So, well, if you look at the biotechs, there's a lot of different disease states where you're trying to target specific cell areas, right, without damaging other cell areas. And that can be with cancer therapy, oncology, that could be with autoimmune diseases, that could be with inflammatory diseases. So if you look on the news and you hear about a biologics, we touch 18 of the largest 25, and with over 120 molecules currently in development, 20 in commercial production, we're one of the leading sites for producing biologics.
Bloomington is really known for having a strong pocket of life sciences company. Does that legacy there help create momentum for you to grow your work at Catalent?
It really does. And when you look at the industry, there's been waves that have driven longer lifespans over time. You know, if you go back to the invention of aspirin as we know it today, which happened in the early 1900s, the lifespan was around 46 years. We're up to 76 today, and I think that trend is driven by a series of technology improvements in medical care. And some of the pioneers are in this area, and are Hoosiers, such as with Eli Lilly, such as with Bill Cook down in Bloomington. That is a legacy. Now I think biologics is the next wave. And we're leveraging the skill sets and the people and the knowledge that we're lucky enough to have in the area.
And just the beginning of the wave. Thank you for being here, Dennis, and good luck with the growth.
Thank you.
Gary, back to you.